This is a LiDAR 360 version 5.0 tutorial. We will focus on industry applications including mine, power line, and vector file editing. Starting with the mining module, including
track tunnel points, compute normal vectors, triangulation modeling, Poisson modeling, and other functions. The extract tunnel points tool generates the center axis by importing from files or manually drawing and then remove the noise inside the tunnel along the center axis and generate a new file. Click the manual drawing button to draw a polyline with the left mouse button and double-click to end the drawing. The tunnel is longitudinally sectioned along the center axis. With this step length, the step size affects the efficiency and precision of the algorithm. The thickness of the tunnel refers to the average distance from the inner wall of the tunnel to the surface of the tunnel. The tunnel width refers to the maximum width of the contour section in the tunnel, which determines the extraction range of the point cloud on both sides of the center axis. The Compute Normal Vectors tool calculates the normal vector of the tunnel. Search radius defines the neighborhood search radius for obtaining neighboring points, and then the algorithm calculates the normal direction based on these points. When the orientation option is checked, the minimum spanning tree will be used to optimize the consistency of the normal direction. Once the normals are calculated, the additional attribute normals can be used to render the point clouds. To do this, right-click on the point cloud file, go to View Mode, and click on Display Additional Attributes by RGB. You can then tell whether the normal calculation is reasonable by observing the color and consistency of the normals. You may recalculate normals if the color looks inconsistent and colorize the point cloud again afterward. Poisson modeling generates 3D model files in OBJ format. The point cloud must be processed with compute normal vectors. Every node sample defines the minimum number of points retained in each node. Reconstruction is mainly used to weaken the influence of noise on the reconstruction result. The larger the weight value, the closer the reconstructed implicit triangulation surface is to the original point cloud resolution of the reconstructed implicit triangulation surface. The Display Wireframe tool can switch display modes of models and current window to triangle mesh mode. The Powerline module is used for processing and analysis of Powerline point cloud, including settings, mark tower, classify dangerous point detection, and clear danger points. Click on the Real-Time Condition Analysis button and the Settings window will pop up automatically. After clicking in the point cloud data and choosing the tower type, user can save the result into a tower file. After adding the position information of the tower, the software will automatically generate the index and name information of the tower. Index is a number starting from the starting value and incrementing by 1. Tower type includes non-tension tower and straight-line tower. Double-click the row for each tower to jump to that tower in the display window. The Classify tool can be used to classify the point cloud into transmission tower, power line, ground points, noise, and other selected classes. This function can process multiple data simultaneously and perform segmentation classification and noise removal in one step. The Detect Danger Points tool can be used to batch process the point cloud file to generate the dangerous points image and reports based on the tower file. Please refer to the user manual for parameter settings. The Clear User Data tool can be used to clear all the danger point detection results in the point cloud. Once cleared, all the danger points will be changed into non-danger points. Vector Editor can realize the vectorization in the process of drawing digital line. It provides high contrast display effects based on the well-displayed point cloud with image data as the background. Therefore, the function can clearly distinguish houses, vegetation areas, roads, streetlights, water areas, bridges, and other objects. Moreover, it can generate vectorized results in shape and DXF format, which supports subsequent editing and processing with other third-party software such as ArcGIS and AutoCAD. The Select Vector File option can select the vector object data that has been loaded into the editing window. Select the data to be edited. The New Temporary Scratch Vector option constructs a temporary editing panel in the editing window, and the vector editing can be carried out The edited vector data is loaded into the directory tree as a temporary object, and the window vector editing is managed with layers, which means a file is treated as a layer. The link viewer loads other types of data in the same area, such as tin data, raster data, for auxiliary editing. Editing such as drawing lines, drawing points, and building boundary extraction can be done in a linked viewer. The elevation filter can filter out the inference points after setting the center position in the buffer. The filtered point set is displayed in the scene, the Z value range of the points displayed after elevation. Filtering are all within the buffer zone, with the position as the value center. Select 3 points to draw the rectangle, which is not parallel with the coordinate axis. By mouse interaction, left-click the mouse to select point A, or click the right mouse button to cancel. Left-click the mouse to select point B, or click the right mouse button to return to step 1. Left-click the mouse to select point C. Continue to draw the next rectangle, or click right button to return to step 2. Right-click the mouse to end drawing. For more complex objects, the Draw Polygon tool can be used, drawing polygon by the mouse interaction. Left-click the mouse to choose a vertex of polygon, or click the right mouse button to cancel. Left-click the mouse to choose one more point, or click the right mouse button to return back to step 1. Right-click the mouse to end the drawing. Click the Draw by Intersection button to activate the function. Click the left mouse button to select 2 points on one side of the building. In turn, click the left mouse button to select 2 points on the other side of the building. In turn, the 2 selected edges will automatically extend to meet the intersection point. There are other optional operations for this function. Please refer to the user manual for more information. Use the Profile Editor tool to check the profile view of the data. Drawing the building facade structure by using the Draw Polygon and Polyline tools. Edit polygon and a node by mouse interaction. Left-click the mouse to select the polygon that you want to edit, or click the right mouse button to cancel. Left-click the mouse to choose the location of the polygon entity and add nodes to the position. Users can also click the right mouse button to return to step 1. Right-click the mouse to end editing. Appending nodes at the start or end of the polyline by the mouse interaction. Left-click the mouse to select polyline that you want to edit, or click the right mouse button to cancel. Left-click the mouse to select the point and determine the position of the inserted point, according to the distance. If it is closer to the starting point, the point will be appended before the starting point. Otherwise, it will be appended after the end point. Users can also click the right mouse button to cancel the editing of the polyline and return to step 1. Right-click the mouse to end appending. Edit polygon and delete node by mouse interaction. The operation procedures are similar to end node. Reshape lines or polygons by drawing sketches on selected features. The feature adopts the sketch shape connected from the first intersection to the last intersection of the sketch. In the feature, left-click to select the polyline or polygon entity. Right-click to exit editing. Pick points in the scene. Double-click to finish the editing. Cut polygon by the drawn line. Left-click to select the polyline or polygon entity. Right-click to exit editing. Pick points in the scene. Double-click to finish the editing. The Entity Modify tool provides many basic functions, such as move, copy, rotate, and scale copying entities to one copy or multiple copies, which can create the same entities in different locations. In addition, multiple entities can be created with the same offset increment. By this function,
rotate entities to get one copy or multiple copies at different rotation angles. In addition, multiple entities can be created with the same angle increment, scale entities, to get one copy or multiple copies at different scales in different locations. For detailed steps, please refer to the user manual. Click and edit to end the vector editing. After ending editing, a prompt box will pop up to save the editing results. After the user makes a selection as required, the editing function is exited and other functions of the toolbar will be grayed out. The element extraction module is used to extract elements in the scene. Semi-automatic building is one of the available functions. When starting any function of this module, if there is no layer currently, the software will automatically add a layer. The vectorized objects drawn by any function of this module will be stored on the layer. Click the Extract Building Outline button, and the Parameter Configuration interface will pop up for the dividing roof layer. Option check to extract outline by building roof, unchecked to extract overall boundary. The inner and outer options defines the extract to be either in or outline or out or outline. Min area refers to the minimum area of entity to extract. Point spacing refers to the average distance between points for the regularization. Option check to regularize the outlines. Angle tolerance of regularization range from 15 to 30 degrees. The higher of the degree, the less sharp edges. Click the undo button to undo the last edit or click the redo button to redo the last edit. Another available function in the element extraction module is called the Extract Road Ridge. Click the Extract Road Ridge button to activate this function. Move the left button of the mouse and the scene will recognize whether the mouse position is in a plane, an intersection ridge, or an intersection corner in real time. When an intersecting ridge appears, click the mouse to extract the ridge. The ridge line is vectorized into a polyline and added to the road layer. For parameter settings and more vectorization options, please refer to the user manual.